History doesn't repeat itself, Mark Twain once quipped, but it often rhymes. And right now, it's rhyming in Chinese. For the Colson Center, I'm John Stone Street. This is Breakpoint. In November of 1938, Nazi paramilitary forces destroyed 267 synagogues plus thousands of Jewish-owned businesses, institutions, and homes throughout the Reich. Kristallnacht, or the Night of Broken Glass, made clear what awaited Jews under Nazi control. Even as the Jewish victims of this Nazi violence were forced to clean up the broken glass and indemnify their persecutors, the world did nothing. It couldn't even bring itself to offer refuge to Jews fleeing Nazi persecution. This inaction gave rise to a phrase that's now permanently associated with Israel and the Jews throughout the world. Never again. History cannot be allowed to repeat itself. Well, it is. In a recent Washington Post op-ed, Fred Hiatt, who's Jewish, wrote that in China, every day is Kristallnacht. The comparison to Nazi Germany is especially powerful when you learn that Hiatt's grandfather founded an organization to help settle Jewish refugees after World War II. In other words, Hiatt's comparison is not made lightly. In the article, he calls Beijing's war on its Muslim Uyghur population a cultural genocide with few parallels since World War II. This cultural genocide includes imprisoning 1 million Uyghurs in concentration camps, where aging imams are shackled and young men are forced to renounce their faith. There are also credible reports of beatings, rape, denial of basic medical care, even organ harvesting. Not only is Beijing imprisoning Uyghurs, it's eliminating their history. Between 10 and 15,000 mosques, shrines, and other religious sites have been destroyed. As Hiatt writes, anything that looks too Islamic is flattened, even a dome on top of a department store. A new report entitled Demolishing Faith, the Destruction and Desecration of Uyghur Mosques and Shrines, provides all the evidence we need. Before and after satellite photographs reveal the extent of the destruction in Western China. You can see with your own eyes how mosques have been turned into parking lots and Muslim cemeteries erased. By reproducing these photos, Hiatt has made it impossible for Beijing to deny what it's actually doing, cultural genocide. Hiatt and the Washington Post have done the world a valuable service here. Now we're left with a question. What have we learned in the last 81 years? For the sake of the Uyghurs, not to mention the Chinese Christians whose faith is also being targeted by Xi Jinping and his henchmen, I hope we have an adequate answer. We often say things like seeing is believing, but to paraphrase writer Upton Sinclair, it's difficult to get someone to look when they're getting paid depends on not looking. Too many corporations, governments, and other institutions are refusing to look at China right now. The NBA is the only most recent and obvious example, but their response is like a profile in courage compared to the non-response of companies such as Apple, not to mention so many in academia, Hollywood, video game companies, and the government. As Chinese human rights lawyer Ting Bao puts it, the West kowtows to China through self-censorship. Even more, China now is exporting its authoritarianism to other countries. In other words, Beijing is not only a threat to its own people anymore. Christians must do whatever we can to make people look, with all the painful clarity, at the persecution of religious minorities in China. We must care. We must call our leaders to care. Business as usual with a regime committing cultural genocide is no more acceptable today than it was 81 years ago. There can be no excuse for doing nothing yet again. For Breakpoint, I'm John Stone Street.